put that there so you can actually, like, kind of see the flame. Sure, that works. What's up, witches? Tiffany here, and I'm very excited because today we're talking about Mabon. I'm just really excited because fall is my favorite season, and Mabon always comes like right after my birthday. And then of course Samhain and Halloween are coming up, so it's a good time of year all around. I've even already got my pumpkins out to cover both Mabon and Samhain. I'm prepared, I'm ready, let's do this. 2020 has been a terrible year for everybody across the board, but this is something I'm looking forward to. All right, so here we go. What is Mabon and how do you celebrate it? So Mabon is the fall or autumnal equinox, depending on, you know, what you like to call it, fall or autumn. And this year it will be on Tuesday, September 22nd of the year 2020. So Ostara, the spring equinox, is its opposite on the other side of the year. And of course, while us in the northern hemisphere are celebrating Mabon, those in the southern hemisphere are celebrating Ostara. So both of those days in the year are when night and day are of equal lengths. There is perfect balance. And we know that after this, night is going to continue to get longer and longer, and the days are going to get shorter. We are returning to the dark, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. Mabon is also the day of the mid-harvest festival, often also known as the second harvest. Because if you remember, Lammas is the first harvest. So now we get to enjoy the abundance that we have received and give thanks. And we give thanks as we also bid the sun adieu. Now with this tradition, I want you to keep in mind that the original American Thanksgiving took place on October 3rd, which makes a lot more sense with the seasons. So it's a time to be grateful. And then now that the second harvest is over, it is time to take a bit of a break. Give yourself a little rest. After all, the harshness of winter isn't here yet. Neither is the dark. So this is the time to just relax a little bit while you still can. So overall, Mabon is about balance, appreciation, and rest. If you're looking to decorate your home or your altar, look for seasonal crops like grapes, pears, apples, pumpkins, or any kind of gourds, blackberries, so on and so forth. And if you can arrange them in a little cornucopia, that's always fun and cute too. You can put out symbols of balance and duality, put out some fall leaves. I mean, of course, who doesn't love the look of fall leaves? And if you're looking at a color scheme, well, just look at the regular classic autumn colors. Yellow, red, orange, gold, copper, bronze. Decorate in these colors, wear these colors, light candles in these colors. If you want to do specific spell work empowered by Mabon, look into spells that are going to prepare you for the soon-to-come winter. Do protective spells, defensive spells, spell work for peace of mind and inner strength to get you through the winter months. Like I said, darkness is on the horizon, you'll want to be prepared. Also, any kind of spell to restore balance is going to be greatly empowered by Mabon. And just for fun, you could do apple magic. After all, just cut an apple in half and look at the beautiful pentagram inside. If you're looking for activities to celebrate Mabon, this is a great time to share in your bounty. Do some charity work or donate to a good cause. It's also a great time to clear out the old, so if you collect a bunch of items you've been meaning to get rid of, go donate them somewhere. Because this is also a time of letting go of things you don't need. The cycle of the year is soon coming to an end. So maybe consider doing a cleansing of your living space to just kind of clear out what you don't need. And I mean that both magically and in a mundane sense. In that same regard, complete any projects that you've left unfinished. Find a nearby orchard that allows guests to come in and go apple picking. Take a meditative stroll or a nap in nature. Plant some bulbs now that are going to sit and rest in the earth throughout winter and then start to grow in the early spring. Bake an apple or a pumpkin pie. That's one of my favorites. Make a list of things that you are thankful for. And you know what? In that same vein, make sure to leave out thanks and offerings to anybody who has helped you this past year. Whether that's a god, goddess, ancestors, whoever you use to help amplify your powers that you call upon for assistance, make sure to take a moment to appreciate what they've done. This is pretty much our Thanksgiving. But speaking of Thanksgiving, have a feast. Safely this year, of course, I know it's hard to have people over, but if you can, make several dishes out of the crops of the season and have friends and family over, just to give them some of your time and show them your appreciation for them. And because it's fun, and who doesn't like food? I will tell you right now, I am personally thankful for each and every single one of you. And I mean that sincerely, not just in one of those like, I'm on YouTube and people watch me and so I say things to make them like me. No, I mean it. I'm like legitimately thankful for all of you. And I really do want to hear from you. So I would love to hear how you plan on celebrating Mabon, or maybe how you celebrated last year or years before. Leave those in the comments below. Or if you have like a really delicious apple pie recipe, leave that for me in the comments below. Or you can always send it to me through an email or a message on Instagram, or just send me whatever you like, as long as it's not like inappropriate. If you had fun and enjoyed this video, maybe learned something new, hit that thumbs up, and if you're not already subscribed, please do so. I'd love to have you join my little channel. Ding the little bell so you get notifications, of course. I release videos every Wednesday evening at 7 p.m. and every Sunday morning at 7 a.m. That is all California time. I think at the point of the release of this video, Mabon's only like 2 days away, so hurry up, make your plans, get your decorations put out if you haven't already. And for now, I'm going to sign off wishing all of you a wonderful, wonderful fall equinox. I'll see you all soon.